Lucchese crime family, pronounced Lux, is one of the five families that dominates organized crime activities in New York City, United States, within the nationwide criminal phenomenon known as the Mafia, or Cosa Nostra. The family originated in the early 1920s with Gaetano Reina serving as boss up until his murder in 1930. It was taken over by Tommy Gagliano during the Castellammarese War, and led by him until his death in 1951. The family under Gagliano was peaceful and low-key, concentrating their criminal activities in the Bronx, Manhattan and New Jersey. The next boss was Tommy Lucchese, who turned the family around to become one of the most powerful families to sit on the commission. Lucchese teamed up with Gambino crime family boss Carlo Gambino to control organized crime in New York City. When Lucchese died of natural causes in 1967, Carmen Tramundi controlled the family for a brief time. He was arrested in 1973. Anthony Corallo then gained control of the family. Corallo was very secretive and soon became one of the most powerful members of the commission. He was arrested and convicted in the famous commission case of 1986. For most of its history, the Lucchese family was reckoned as one of the most peaceful crime families in the nation. However, that changed when Corallo named Victor Amuso his successor shortly before going to prison. Amuso later promoted one of his longtime partners, Anthony Casso, to underboss. They instituted one of the bloodiest reigns in mafia history, ordering virtually anyone who crossed them to be murdered. Amuso was arrested in 1991 and sentenced to life in prison. Several Lucchese wise guys, fearing for their lives, turned informant. The highest profile of these was acting boss Alphonse Darko, who became the first boss of a New York crime family to testify against the mob. This led to the arrest of the entire Lucchese family hierarchy, with Casso also becoming an informant. Testimony from these informants nearly destroyed the family, with as many as half of its members incarcerated. Amuso has continued to rule the family from prison. The early history of the Lucchese crime family can be traced to members of the Morello gang based in East Harlem and the Bronx. Gaetano Tommy Reina would leave the Morellos around the time of World War I and created his own family based in East Harlem and the Bronx. As the family's leader, Reina avoided the Mafia Camorra war for control over New York City. He instead focused on controlling the home ice distribution business throughout New York City. 2. During the early 1920s, Reina became a powerful Prohibition-era boss and aligned himself with Joseph Masseria, the most powerful Italian-American crime boss in New York. Masseria soon became involved in the Castellammarese War, a vicious gang war with rival Sicilian boss Salvatore Maranzano. At this point, Masseria started demanding a share of Reina's criminal profits, prompting Reina to consider changing allegiance to Maranzano. When Masseria learned of Reina's possible betrayal, he plotted with Reina's lieutenant Tommy Gagliano to kill him. On February 26, 1930, gunman Vito Genovese murdered Reina outside his aunt's apartment. With Reina dead, Masseria bypassed Gagliano, who expected to take control of the Reina gang, and installed his underling Joseph Faggio Pinsolo as boss. Furious with this betrayal, Gagliano and Tommy Lucchese secretly defected to Maranzano. In September 1930, Lucchese lured Pinsolo to a Manhattan office building, where Pinsolo was murdered. With Masseria's murder in early 1931, Maranzano outlined a peace plan to all the Sicilian and Italian mafia leaders in the United States. There would be 24 organizations, to be known as families, throughout the country who would elect their own bosses. Maranzano also reorganized all the Italian-American gangs in New York City into five families to be headed by Maranzano: Lucky Luciano, Vincent Mangano, Tommy Gagliano and Joseph Profasi. Gagliano was awarded the old Reina organization, with Lucchese as his underboss. The final element of Maranzano's peace plan was that he would become the supreme leader of the American Mafia, the Capo di Tutti Capi, boss of all bosses. However, Luciano and other mob members did not want another top leader. When Renzano learned about Luciano's disaffection, he hired a gunman to kill him. However, in September 1931, Luciano struck first. Several Jewish assassins provided by Luciano associate Meyer Lansky murdered Renzano in his office. Luciano now became the most powerful mobster in New York. Luciano kept the family structure as created by Renzano, but removed the boss of bosses in favor of a ruling body, the Commission. The Commission's responsibility was to regulate the family's affairs and resolve all differences between the families. The first Commission members included Luciano, Gagliano, Bonanno, Profossi, Mangano, Chicago outfit boss Al Scarface Capone and Buffalo family boss Stefano Magadino, with Luciano as chairman. 3. Although the Commission was technically a democratic institution, it was actually controlled by Luciano and his allies. During the 1930s and 1940s, Gagliano and Lucchese led their family into profitable areas of the trucking and clothing industries. When Luciano was sent to prison for pandering in 1936, a rival alliance took control of the commission. The alliance of Mangano, Bonanno, Buffalo crime family boss Stefano Magadino, and Profossi used their power to control organized crime in America. Understanding his vulnerability, Gagliano was careful to avoid opposing this new alliance. Gagliano was a quiet man who avoided the media and stayed off the streets. He